there's always been guilt and sin associated with gambling and in the West, and these guys were doing something that was awfully popular and was now legal.
Hey Trav, what's up? I'm going over some of the games today. Did you play any yet? Can I read some to you and see if you agree or not? Richmond, strong play. What about 823 Vermont?
What have you heard of the Cornell Temple game? Because I'm hearing two-sided action.
Northern Iowa seems to be the trendy pick for the squares, but I think the right side is UNLV.
731 Murray State.
Did I mention East Tennessee State? Minnesota, did we talk about that? 845. Did I mention Wisconsin? 834.
Who's had a long layoff? Oh, yeah. Right.
Louisville is getting a point and a half. I think they're setting that game up. ODU. You love ODU? So do I.
Hello?
Lost him.
So you're playing a lot of games.
Yeah. The more games, the better, if you have an edge over the bookmaker. For instance, if I'm expecting to have a 5% hold in a short number of games, I could end up losing. But if I bet like 100 or 200 games in a week, which is not unusual during a college basketball, there's a much more of a chance that I'll sustain the edge on a regular basis if I go with more games.
Ooh.
There's a account that I have access to. They're very clever in this account here. I want to show you something. Not many people have access to this, but a lot of people move for a man that I used to work for, namely Billy Walters.
If money talks, it ain't on speaking terms with me. It don't get close enough for such familiarity.